If I could be one famous person. I should have thought about this before I sat down. Okay. Let me think. First person that came to mind was Morgan Freeman, just because of how awesome he was. But I don't want to say that because, like, everyone wants to be him.
Okay, I got it. Okay, so I'm going to have Ciara's dance moves, Michelle Obama's brains, and Jay-Z's money. Yep. Or Tommy Hilfiger's money. Or Tom Ford. Tom Ford's money. Yes, Tom Ford's money. That's what I want.
I'll be Jackie Chan just because he's one of the best movie stars I know.
Well, I've seen a lot of interviews with Jennifer Lawrence, and she advocates young girls to be comfortable with their bodies, and I really respect her for that because I think that's a really important that's really important for young girls to have that influence in today's society.
I think I would be, I'd like to be Daniel Day-Lewis because he's like a phenomenal actor, and really that's what I want to be. So yeah, Daniel Day-Lewis.
I would be Henry Cavill because he's so attractive and I would just stare at myself in the mirror all day long.
I would be Toby Keith because, like, I'm a country person and I like country songs.
I would be Ava Gabor because she has an awesome voice, she's really pretty, she was in a lot of really good movies, and she's just all around pretty awesome. So I would be Ava Gabor.
Beyonce is very beautiful. She's very successful. She's an icon, and I clearly am not. So I want to be Beyonce.
I think I'd be Emily Sandé. She really inspires me so much because I've listened to her songs over and over again, and I find her writing to be like completely amazing. And as a songwriter, I find her to be very inspiring, and I love the way she writes. And whenever I listen to like her songs, I feel really inspired to write songs as well, because I feel like if she can write such beautifully lyrical songs in such an eloquent way, then I can manage it too. I just really love her songwriting a lot.
I'd be an animator named Rebecca Sugar. I just think her amazing creativity and her focus with her ideas and her concepts and her cartoon. Her focus on what she thinks is right with what the cartoon should be, the direction the cartoon should be going into is really astounding. I think if I could be any person, I'd be her because I think she has a good direction of what her life's going to.
I don't know, I've always thought that Johnny Depp was really cool just because he's always so relaxed all the time and he's just really modest, especially with his roles. But you know, even though he just plays such amazing characters.
I'd have to say I would want to be a famous cat, probably. Like Tartar Sauce, the grumpy cat. They have really easy lives. Is that okay to say? Because that's not a person.
That's fine.
So I would be Tartar Sauce, the grumpy cat.
Being an artist, there's no question that I'd pick another artist. I've spent my life being an artist for a reason. I believe that we make a contribution, and certainly I would pick someone who makes a great contribution, and that person would be Leonardo da Vinci.
The first thing that came to mind was Mary Pfeiffer, who is a psychotherapist out in Nevada and has written several really wonderful books about healing. And I'm a therapist myself, so I find her writings very inspiring, and she seems to live a very deeply satisfying kind of life. From what I can tell, who knows, that's just her public persona. But that was my first thought, so that's my answer.
I don't know, I don't have much desire to be a famous person. It's true, I mean, Generally, famous people can be entertaining, but generally they're kind of weird. You know, I mean, I don't see like people on TV that I'm really envious of. You know, maybe certain aspects, like who wouldn't like a little bit more money, you know? But I don't know, I feel like I work pretty hard at being who I am, so I'm kind of happy with that.
Leonardo da Vinci changed the way people saw each other. He took a psychological point of view. One of the first artists to really look at the deep complexity of a person. Besides that, he was an artist of what they say, the Renaissance person. He was an architect. He was an artist of many dimensions.
All of the famous people who I admire, I wouldn't want to be, because they all have really tough lives, because they're all hardworking people who caused controversy.
I would be Malala Yousafzai, who is a 16-year-old girl who was shot by the Taliban and has about a year ago and has since recovered. And she's just released a book titled I Am Malala about her story and her fight for equality. Because she was shot mostly because she was fighting so loudly for equality and education for girls and women. And the Taliban disagreed with her views, and so they tried to kill her. Self-actualize, is that the term? I don't know. Like, complete and like, okay, I'm good, thanks. I mean, obviously she has so much more to do, and I would try and do as much as I could too, but like,
again,
yeah.
And I guess the first thing that you would have to consider is, if you're this famous person, does that mean that you suddenly have all of their memories up until that point, or do you just become them? Because, I mean, I think that if you're all of a sudden put in this famous person's place, I would probably choose somebody really rich and in a position of power. However, if it were more like I both retain my memories and I sort of became this famous person, then I might choose somebody who's had a really big impact on a certain field. So I'm a writer, I really like criticism, so I might choose someone like Roger Ebert, the famous film critic, or one of my favorite film critics, Matt Zoller Seitz, is a really great guy who would be really interesting to be. Maybe if it were just for a couple days, that would be a cool experience.
Actually, there's a guy, his name is Alan Lomax, a very interesting man. He is responsible for preserving a lot of American folk music that is still around today. They'd go to prisons, they'd go to the fields where people were working, they'd go everywhere they could find music, and they'd record it. And so they discovered hundreds and hundreds of musicians and recorded. They made tens of thousands of recordings with these people. I think if I could be someone famous or of importance, I would like to be someone like that, because I think, number one, they've led a very interesting life, and they also contributed a lot to their culture and their society.